In this video, we're going to look at the Harwich to Hoek of Holland ferry route as it was in the 1980s, before the advent of cheap airlines and of Eurostar. From London and the north of the UK, trains used to converge at Harwich, where passengers could board the ferry to the Hoek of Holland. In the early 80s, the route was run by two British ships, the St Edmund and the St George, and two Dutch ships, the Princess Beatrix and the Zeeland. On the UK side, following a long historical tradition, there was a train then known as the European, which was loco-hauled, and ran from Glasgow through Manchester, Nottingham, Sheffield, Peterborough, Ely and Harwich, It ran on the Settle and Carlisle line at first, but was later diverted to the West Coast Main Line north of Manchester. Leaving Glasgow at 11 a.m, you were able to get to Harwich for the ship that night, so able to arrive at Amsterdam in less than 24 hours, before 11 a.m. the next morning. From London, boat trains ran from Liverpool Street to meet both the day and the night sailings. One of the most dramatic changes to the route happened in 1983 with the introduction of the revolutionary St Nicholas. At the time, this was the most impressive ferry in the UK, with room for nearly 500 cars, a restaurant, a coffee shop, cinema, shop, and most memorably of all, a terraced nightclub bar with a stage at the back of the ship, giving a true impression of being on a cruise ship and something very different. The ship was ahead of its time and made mini cruises more attractive than ever. Several options were consistently offered throughout the 1980s. Very popular was the Amsterdammer overnight excursion, from which from the UK you could take an overnight ferry in each direction, giving you a whole day in Amsterdam. There was also a shorter excursion, taking the day boat out and the night boat back, known for a time as the Windmiller excursion. This included the train fare to and from Rotterdam. The brochure here is interesting, suggesting all the places in Rotterdam you can visit, before rounding the trip off with a visit to the Euromast, but quite how you're supposed to do all that in 2 hours, I'm not quite sure, especially as the Euromast is about a 15-minute tram ride from Rotterdam station. Mini cruises were also run in the opposite direction, from the Netherlands to the UK. This one from the Netherlands, which ran for a time, and included a coach tour to Colchester. The possibility of travelling to London from the Netherlands was also promoted, as were other rail connections. Once upon a time, the traveller getting off at Hoek could choose from trains going to Copenhagen, Germany, Italy, and even Moscow. But sadly, no longer is there the wonderful collection of multinational trains waiting for the ships to come in. Sealink were so pleased with their new ship, they promoted a so-called executive first-class ticket between London and the Netherlands, which even had its own loyalty card system, the Double H Club. The St Nicholas did indeed have some impressive conference rooms, which we would hope would add to the appeal for the business community, as well as its upmarket facilities. In 1987, the route took a further leap upwards, with the introduction from the Dutch side of their new ship, the Koningen Beatrix. This complemented the St Nicholas, replacing what had up to then been an inferior partnership. This was an even larger ship than the St Nicholas. It had a very upmarket feel to it, and taking a cruise type ship in each direction certainly made for memorable excursions and mini cruises. A whole variety of different short term, day, overnight, and longer fares were offered to tempt people on board. Going back to the rails, as time progressed, in 1987 the train service from Scotland to Harwich was changed. No longer did it run from Glasgow through Manchester, Sheffield and Nottingham, but instead it went down the whole West Coast Main Line as far as Watford Junction, pulling off to then go round the top of London to stop at Shenfield, Chelmsford and Colchester before arriving at Harwich. By all accounts, this was not a great success, the train being quite empty in the latter half of its run once it gets south of Birmingham. Meanwhile, to serve Manchester, Nottingham and Peterborough, a new train, the Rhinelander, was introduced. At first this was loco-hauled, but soon it degenerated into a sprinter service, which often suffered from overcrowding. As far as the London to Harwich route was concerned, the boat trains were given the names of Benjamin Britten and Admiral de Ruyter, and marketed as part of the new Eurocity network. As with so many things in the past, many aspects of the Hook-Harwich service are not what they were now, but, at least at the time of this video, the service still exists. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please like, share, subscribe. More to follow in due course.